Thank you. Thank you. Don't say I was muted all of the time. Was I? Oh, that's a rookie mistake. Let me, can I listen back on Twitch? Probably not. Oh wow, that's annoying, to say the least. Sorry. Sorry. So, for people who haven't heard it, what I'm trying to do is create an API which will call multiple backend APIs, and in the end this front-facing API, secureAPI.API, will have to authorize itself using its managed identity to the backend APIs, and the backend APIs will check if this service can or cannot access the data. So I'll be using managed identities for this, and well, Azure Active Directory, obviously. What I want to do today is I'll create these APIs. So I have three APIs at the moment, and what I want to do is create an create an ARM template which will deploy everything in Azure what I need. So I think it's one app service plan with three app services inside. Oh, I'm really bummed. I was muted for the first, 45 minutes. Maybe I should create a big flashing light on the screen. Is there something like a big flashing light? Big flashing light when muted. Software. Not really something. Maybe I should create something myself later. My stream deck also shows it, so that's why I noticed there was a cross in my microphone. Okay, well, let's just start creating ARM templates. So what I need to do now is create a new file. SecureAPI.deploy. And of course a parameters file. secureAPI.deployment.parameters.json. I will only deploy one environment, so I don't need multiple. Typo. Okay. Sorry. There's probably some default scheme. So Refresh Manager template reference. Quick start. Tag resources. I never remember how to start in an ARM template. Edit and deploy. Begins tutorial. copy and paste the following resources. Yeah. Is this enough? Hopefully. I guess this is the latest version parameters. Okay, cool. So that's this one. Now for the parameters file. Add resource. Yes, I know this stuff. Add parameters. Parameters deploy. Use a parameter file. Add parameter file. So this is a parameter file. I don't need all of this stuff. Yes. Cool. Existing items. Cool. Amend. Quickly push, push. So as I mentioned, I need one service plan, three app services inside this service plan. Should be easy enough. Azure Resource Manager Template Reference. Web. So I need a hosting environment, and this hosting environment needs a server farm, if I'm not mistaken. Yes. Most of this stuff is optional. So the name what will be the name? Server farm. So it will be secure API form. So that's this one, API version kind. What? They mean kind of resource, not necessary. Location is the resource group where we're deploying to, resource group dot location tags. I'll be using it for now. Worker tier name. Properties. SKU. SKU isn't mandatory. Interesting. Host environment profile name. Free offer reserved. Let's say reserved to false. I want to deploy it to Windows. Boolean, so it's without the quotes. All of this isn't necessary from what I can see. And I think the hosting environment profile name isn't either hosting environment. App service environment. I won't be using ACE. Target worker tier assigned to the app service plan. So that's nice and small. SKU. Name of the resource SKU. Tier size. Quick start templates. App service, ACE, function app. Create a function app with managed identity, Windows, deploy a basic Windows web app. Let's see what the values SKU. Okay, so they have stuff over here. Hey, they're not. Let me focus. Properties depends on SKU. Well, that's a bit what I have. I have this property stating I'm on a Windows environment and SKU. Name. Name? Only name is necessary. And what do we have as a name? Default value S1. Okay. Farm. I only have one environment. SKU S1. So I don't need this as a parameter. Server farm dot SKU. Apparently I don't need any of these, which I find interesting. Location. Oh, I was under the impression you always need a hosting plan. Apparently not. So, format document, server form, APIs. Called backend for frontend. Instance name. instance name API backend. No, API, let's just call it API. No, this won't work because it probably need a prefix because it has to be unique. Project prefix. Yum page cure API. Concat. Frontend. Now I need the, which project should I have? Conferences and speakers. Speakers. APIs never used. Now it will be. APIs dot backend for frontend dot instance name. Location. App service plan name. Oh. Server farm dot instance name. Depends on. So I quickly want to check Azure why I don't need a hosting plan for a simple hosting environments. Are they only necessary for an ace? Okay, so I only need the server farm and the site. Do I need more? Not at this moment. Slots might be useful. We'll add them later on. Deployments, app settings. App settings can be useful. I won't be using them. Yes, I will be using them. Auth settings. Do I need them now? Web app with an Azure database for MySQL. Nested resource for this. need them now. Oh, I can't wait a minute. Websites config object. Websites slash config. Sorry. Normally I just copy paste this stuff. Some sample. Is there a sample over here? Some deployment slots, maybe. Not really, Octo3. What are you saying? Is. Oh, this is a different notation. Isn't there another file I can use? Not really. So let me see what they have over here. Where is this? This is in the websites, resources. Oh, I have to create this one. Actually makes sense. I've seen this before. So I'm going to see stuff, you know how it should work. Website name is this. .NET version, don't need this, WebSockets, always on, why wouldn't I, true, HTTP, logging, okay, and this one, Did I copy it wrong? Properties name. No, this should be, according to this, it should be correct. Don't say anything, of course. I want to check out one of my CLI commands. Oh, I want to deploy the stuff to the Azure portal. So let me create a resource group. Resource groups. Add. Come on. Add. Go live coding secure API. West Europe. Is it busy? Look up how to using Azure Managed Identity, deploy an ARM template. I don't need to do this, this is for link templates. So I needed to know this. I have my terminal. Yes. Deployment here. So, Azure group deployment. Right. I can share API. Template file is backtick. I don't have a parameters file, but why not add it? Okay, so this should be it. Is the resource group available now? Yes, it is. So this will probably fail. It always fails the first time for me. Unrecognized parameters. Parameter file. Maybe without the S. Didn't do this wrong. Parameters. Dope. I can't even copy it correctly. Let me copy this to my OneNote over here. As text. As plain text. Running. Wow. No resource to display. Okay, so something. Deployments. The portal isn't very responsive today. There were some issues with DevOps earlier today. Ah, there it is. So maybe, yes, so this worked. It worked the first time. Let's see. Win. Okay, cool. So this is all there is to it. For now. Server farm, let me just copy this 2 more times. Normally I would use linked templates and linked deployments for this to make the stuff more readable instead of one big blob of JSON. But I want to be pragmatic about it because this session isn't about making pretty ARM templates, and also deploying the ARM template manually is a bit of a pain with linked templates, as you have to upload them to some location before you can use them. Or at least to my knowledge. So speakers. I could also have used a copy command for this, which we mentioned in the latest Fortinet webcast. You can find it on my YouTube channel. But still, that's also not necessary for now. It would also mean I have to remove the configuration from this block, as I don't want to copy all of the settings all the time to all applications. But for now, this looks okay-ish. 3 times. 3 times. 3 times. Okay. Okay, yes. See if this works. If someone feels like improving this ARM template, I'm open for pull requests. So, deployment succeeded. Let's see if it's true. Refresh. Maybe it will just add the deployments. I need to do a hard refresh last time also. The portal is rather slow today. But this looks good. No errors. And there it is. 3 app services, 1 app service plan. S1, if I'm not mistaken. Yes. So this will work. Deployments. Oh, sure. It's the same deployment name. I'm using the same deployment name. Sure, makes sense. So it will override it. So I guess this works. Let me just commit it. server on app server's code template. Push. Looking at the time, I think I was correct. So we have this ARM template in place now, which is can be used to deploy the app services. I can do a right-click deployment, but you will probably believe me when I say we can use Azure DevOps to deploy this stuff. I'll create a CI pipeline next session, probably next week. So let me update. Create solution with two API projects. Build pipeline, no. But we have created the ARM template in order to deploy our services to Azure. So this one works. Create the CI build, which will create a package which will get deployed. Add my build pipeline, trigger change on master. Create automated deployment, and then we'll build initiates CI build on master finishes. Okay. So that's this one. Do we need to do more? We can create an issue. Use link templates. Use link templates. Also, use the copy function to deploy the app services and split the other from the and template. Okay, cool. New issue. What's this? Up to 3 bookmark. Have we found any more issues? Well, probably a lot, but so these ones are allocated over here. Should update the README. Maybe I'll do this in my break tomorrow. Similar to one existing issue. Yeah. No, I don't need an issue for this. Milestones. Never used this. Won't today. labels. Send enhancement. Okay. Cool. Labels, documentation. Assigned to, well, myself. I have to do this myself. So that's it for today. So if you have any suggestions on how I can improve this live coding sessions or my coding style or whatever, aside from unmuting myself, because that's a good lesson to learn, please let me know in the chat on my YouTube channel, hit me up on the socials, whatever. Next time, when will I be coding again? I'm planning to code again on the 30th, next Monday, March 30 and March 31, Monday and Tuesday, same time, 8:30, because that's when my kids are asleep, or at least should be asleep. That's it for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time.